Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I'm the Marmoset. I've got a little bit of a cold, not feeling too great, but I'm reasonably happy with how things are going. Do we have a train jam? We do. We do indeed have a train jam. This is going to cause us some problems later. What of you is in blocking? Right, now, here's a thing to note. Looking at this right now, we are simply not got a lot of throughput on these right now, despite the fact that this is full. So I don't necessarily think that we need three stations here. So I'm actually going to delete two of them. Yep, I know you're unhappy, but we've still got the one down here. So I don't think we need all of that, and I am going to delete. All of this road leading back out this way. However, I am going to keep some of the road that comes out because I do want to be able to provide access for my citizens. To get to here. So I will have... that's an out road. So I will put you back across... and then come down, so you can get to here as easy as you possibly can, which will do. I'm going to leave this unzoned, so there's our single road. I'm going to... I have deleted that. And I'm going to delete this as well. And I'm going to have that road, which was a single lane one way. Yep. Come out. Come up. And then come down like that. And we are going to significantly... where's the railways? There it is. Extend that connection that way. And let's see how far we can get under this one. We go straight? Not quite. But we can go quite far. Like that. So we've got plenty of space. The trains are just going to go absolutely bloody mental for a bit while they sort themselves out. That's fine by me. Because there's not the capacity. There simply wasn't enough people heading out to these locations for it to be worth my while. Well, 410 of 3,000. Plenty of space. So, what I'd much rather do is this, and just have one train station that is busy. That suits my needs significantly more. It's a real shame you can't arrange the train stations or have an option on them so that this is an in train station, and this is an out train station. So I could arrange them, the positioning a lot better. But we've got commercial demand, or we have demand, we were thinking business. Do we have a metro line nearby? We do. Good, good. So we can plug it in. Let's start building roads. We wanted a straight line. We want one of these. Come out to about here, if you please. You'd be so kind. And then we will string a district of business. Let's actually just make it slightly less dense than we would otherwise. Which having a bit of a gap between those. Like so, there we go. Right. And I think I probably will... let's have a curve road on the end, shall we? No, let's run off from this end. Curve section like that, so we've got some smaller buildings. Now we want to zone for business. You're all busyness. I do not want you to be busyness. I do not want you to be busyness. I do, however, want a portion of this bit down here to be selected to be high-density commercial to serve their business needs. Business needs. Right. Electrical power cable does tuck in from that corner, but I will run one as we do, cable down the middle of there, cable down the middle of there, cable down the middle of there, and then we will go connect, and then plug that in to the power network there, and now we want water. That mold's now whacked. We don't need garbage too much. We've already got a reasonable amount of garbage connected in over here. Don't think we necessarily need another one. No, I am kind of tempted. What's the pollution map look like? Which is the pollution map? It's that one. And then even that's a bit grotty anyway. What are these eco-friendly companies? Alright, so fine. I don't feel a little bit bad about getting rid of eco-friendly company and putting some kind of heavy industrial wasted district in. I probably don't want to put them up higher on the hill line. I don't know, I just want to make sure these people... And as I said, we've got such vast capacity here that it's fine. We need to worry about it. Water, medical, let's put it in the middle. Let's actually put it in the middle of the district so it has the most effect. Then we'll need... That was medical. We'll need fire. We'll need police. We don't need education. Bus route. Yeah, I figured as much. Just obviously having problems with the side of the road we were on. Down, come on around. And complete. Next we were looking at the metro. So yeah, given the metro connecting over here, we will have the metro connected over here. Let's plug you in there. Nope, we messed that up. I messed that up. Tunnel, come out there. Come out to there. Route. Be so kind as to stop at that station, if you please. That line is getting nice and busy and long. You can at least exchange there to get to the city centre, and that takes you pretty much into everywhere else we're going. So, I don't think that. As we've been building our districts, we do have a decent metro connection to everything. As we're getting further out, we've got less of it, but that's fine by me. This line is probably getting significantly busy. The question whether or not we want to actually make that an endpoint that just goes back and forth and then you change there. I'm kind of happy with what we've got. Got a bus route, got one of those. We need a district. There we go, painting is the way that we go, and now it's Birch Hills. No, this is Business Deer. No, it doesn't work quite well. We've already got bees. What other animals are busy? Ants. Ah, the ant. Ant Hill, Ant Avenues. There we go. Any avenues? No, I said ant avenues. Ant avenues. Because they're ants, and it's an ant hill and all that kind of jazz. Right. Parks, public transport we did. Parks we do need. Plaza with trees. Let's just go with the plaza with trees. We will stick them in said corners. To maximize the overlap. Yep, happy with that. And we will add a basketball court there for the business people. Reasonably happy with how the power is going. Don't have any neat buildings. Oh, what are you? The Hadron Collider. City with a Hadron Collider, need to worry about education. The facility addresses provides for all its citizens, so I can basically get rid of all of my schools. Right. Perhaps not. I get the impression that these are... removes pollution from Land of Walker. Right. Provides all power. Provides all of your citizen health needs. Right, okay, so these are like mega buildings for essentially going, you know what, I couldn't be bothered to actually build a proper city. Well, I've got to the point now where I don't need a proper city. I'm just going to build one of these and it'll all be done and sorted for me. Oh, someone's already moving in already. Yep, done. Don't need the power lines anymore. Sorted. Nice and quick. We've got plenty of industrial demand. And if needs be, and avenues can just extend down over here and wrap around the Lake of Poo. We need to extend it to meet our demands. But in the interim, I just kind of like leaving that empty space. You've got to have an edge on your cities. The nice part we've got about this road section over here and some of its names, you get to define the natural edge of the city, whereas here it's really a case of, I couldn't buy the land, that's why I've got a straight road and couldn't come up to the beach edge. So, this is Animallia, our city. It's not quite full of people yet. Scale Sector and Ant Avenues are still filling up a bit, but we've pretty much reached the end of how far we can go with Animallia. We've filled in its entirety. As the lights come on for night, I'll just pause it here, I think, actually, with the lights coming on as darkness comes, so we can still see a little bit. We've still got the light effect. So, we started off, let's begin the review. We started off with Dalmatian Parks, and this little strip of land down here, where we had our little hexagons that became bee shopping, our tiny little original starter bit of industrial, our little starter bit. I mean, you can see here, the way it doesn't fit in. I tried to preserve this as I was doing the other building work, because I didn't really want to get rid of the original bit of residential that we started with. But there they are, these old buildings tucked in there. And we expanded, and expanded, and expanded, and expanded, and expanded. And now look at our beautiful, beautiful city. We started off by adding the Monkey Strip down here, Dalmatian Parks filled out to this size. Soon afterwards we were looking at the Donkey Mines, which potentially be in the Donkey Woods once we got rid of all the ore. The Jellyfish of Horrors appeared, lurking forever, observing and knowing horrible things, does this jellyfish down on this corner on the shore. Tourist Trap, the Turtle Tourist Trap, soon expanded round all the way round up to here and then connected up to our main highway, proving this link. We filled the area in with vertebrae parks, associated because it does indeed look somewhat like a backbone with ribs. A little Avery kind of triangle district in here when we realize we need just a little bit more commercial. Rather than heading this way on this side of Dalmatian Park, we went this way instead and filled in with the otterways, where we started playing with the canals. Now, I really like the canals. I think they were a really good addition. The only problem is that they are an arse to get roads over, as you saw from the many variations we had on this juncture before we went to our diverging diamond system. Remember the traffic jams we had here, just trying to get people in and out? A lot of that was before we actually put our metro system in, but the canals, you can't dig under them either. So they did prove to be somewhat troublesome in that we had a great deal of trouble, because they were troublesome, getting very much in. I just noticed the steepness of this gap in here. Do we, yeah, it's zoned, it's just too busy for able to get anything in. There's an extra pumping station just tucked in down here, just an extra little bit of pump. Awesome residential buildings along here, the otterways. Where did we go next? Well, we filled the Fiddler Crab in a bit later on, when we started looking at putting this in. But next, we went for Starfish Shores. This was our first mega development, where we went, we need to build a lot in a big scale. So we took a couple of attempts, as it has with all the things, before we developed our diverging diamond and this kind of strange shape thing. Are these two-way roads? There are two-way roads. We originally had a proper roundabout interchange here, but it just snarled up because of the traffic, because City Skylines traffic doesn't like roundabouts so much, but it doesn't like lane changing. Lane changing causes... problems, because they don't change lane early, they don't overtake like you would to go around queues to get somewhere else, they just pile in behind, and they just come to a complete stop when they want to change in, so the lane changing isn't very smooth. So we try roundabout an area that's too busy and it just snarls up, whereas what we've got here, in fact, is traffic that moves reasonably smoothly. You can just see there's no traffic here. Also bear in mind, we put the metro in. So we had Starfish Shores, it's 1, 2, 3, 4 arcs all the way over here. The Starfish Smile, our little residential district, our little commercial district here with its tunnels and connected all these things. But I love some of these walkways. Yeah, I wouldn't want to cycle on that, mate. Yep, you can clip through the landscape. That's how hideous that is. Long roads. Experimenting with long roads, certainly. Where did we go next? Well, Ocelot Air came in a fair bit later, but before we did that, we were building the Feather. Another little, we're just extending our commercial capability, but then we built the Mole Circle. What did we call the Mole Circle? The Mole Circle was an experiment in having an underground roundabout, which all connects in. So what the interesting thing about this is the bus route bounce off this point, so you can go pretty quickly from here to anywhere else. You just need to make sure you're getting on the right one, because they're all numbered the same, because it's all separate, it's all one bus route. So I was quite happy with the kind of feathery shape from this. It worked quite well. Put our nuclear power plant in when we were available for those. You see the busyness of the roadways we've got along here. This is represented by the strip we've got that goes down the center of our city, with our main roads, our airports. It's basically a transport corridor. Well, there was a Wormwood Cross we did quite recently. This main road, really very, very busy with all the various ridiculous junctions we've got. So we've got very large roundabout, diverging diamond, just a single connection point there for the cellular leisure. We've got an offset roundabout in this case, with two main roundabouts here. We've got this just weave of roads connecting up the happy hippo happies with our Donkey Woods industrial area. We've got comes along here, and we've got another diverging, weaving, offset, bizarrely offset diverging diamond, because I just didn't have the space to put it any other way. Crossing over, and just this another big maze of diverging highway diamond here as the roadway that starts. It comes and brings us out. So this slowly but surely expanded. First it stopped off here, and we built Greater Owl Woods. Greater Owl Woods actually came in after we built our menagerie squares. So I've been saving up a lot of what we call the special buildings, and we just dumped them all into this huge, great big square district. I mean, if I grab that building, you can see we've just been piling our special buildings in the center of here. In fact, other than the one out there, the posh mall, everything has basically just been going into the center here. We finished it off with a nice arc on one side when Eagle Skies district came in, and we added also in Hippo Happies here when we had more commercial demand. This resonated the building of this road network around in this corner, where we essentially got to the point where, yep, we need to make sure we can plumb people into this. And then we talked about Spider Industrial, this being the second iteration of it. You see how quickly it's filled out, and just look how freely flowing as I unpause it. The traffic is, compared to the hideous, hideous mess that was previously. Now, we don't actually have a traffic jam at the moment, with people trying to get off here. Yeah, so what we can do is we can fix that by upgrading that to a two-lane road, just to get a few more people on it. There we go. So they'll just fill out and just get off it just a little bit quicker, apparently. I don't quite know what the immediate problem was. It might be just business to do it. Yeah, here's the classic thing I was talking about, the lane changing. There's the lane changing problem. But now switching that over, it's just, I don't know, just unsnarled it briefly, I suppose. And now they're actually filling in. Yeah, because now people who want to get left can just get in. They don't have to go wait and queue up over here. Yeah, so that's filling up and sorting itself out. So that traffic jam is beginning to unsnarl a little bit. Still got a few problems of people trying to get into important locations. But overall, yeah, so the second iteration. Oh, I spy someone who doesn't have any water. The second iteration of Spider Industrial, rather than the rather large and complicated hub that just had everything trying to go through one air at the railway junction, doesn't work. The big thing I learned from that is you need to space everything out. You need to make sure the places the trains have spaces to go where trains need to go. You snarled up again, my trains. Yes, so this is just busy. I've got a lot of freight moving around. A lot of freight moving around. And it just means there's very little I can do about this. Because it's just a junction. I can't fix it. Unless you just see all the trains in the distance. Possibly what we could look at if we were going to be doing more expansions on this, I mean, just look at all my passenger trains snarled up, is I would probably look at getting a mod that gave me one-way railway lines. and I would build an actual proper railway junction in the lieu of some of the road junctions I've got, just so we could get the trains out. Because, wow, this is kind of embarrassingly snarled up. And it's causing problems. We had previous periods where none of our commercial could get anything in, because it was all just stuck on the trains. So be it. Spider Industrial was rebuilt into lots and lots of roads, with our frontage road, with the braid, the web of junctions along here, just keeping things moving, getting the traffic in and out of the city. We filled the gap in with cellular. The mitochondria projects, our nice new high-density zone, went up against our airport. Just wanted some high-density. Amazing how pleased I was how quickly it all filled in. Just gives us a really good shape and filled this district in. Then we're talking about going around the edges. So after we built the owl woods and our circular kind of owl pattern, why is it owl wood? There's the owl eyes, there's the owl belly, possibly the wings coming out the sides with our diverging diamond junctions. A real life roadway thing I'm pretty happy with as the rain falls down. We've got our eelhead point is mostly a services district. We've got plenty of buildings here and there sorted out. All right, so if you guys want to turn around, so those ones have to go all the way out to the end of the dam and back. Whoops. I should be able to fix that with a two-lane road there, which means you should be able to turn around a little bit quicker. Is the dam functioning? No. The dam mostly just holds the poo back. It's filling in, slowly but surely, but this lake is huge. It'll get there eventually. Birdsong District. We found some farmland, so we built upon it. This was the prototype that the new Spider Industrial was built on, with its feeder roads, and these offset junction roads. I can't remember what they're called. They are feeder roads, or frontage roads, yeah, with these frontage roads feeding in, separating the traffic out, the network, industrial area. And after that, it's been the last few episodes where we've been doing a bit of tinkering, we've been building, we've been bankrupting ourselves nearly. Oh no, the cargo terminal is on fire. The fire department will deal with that. Those kind of buildings, to my knowledge, don't necessarily build down. And then we finished off the last few things we've been building. Other extension to Spider Industrial. We built Scale Sector, our triangles. We built Meerkat Mounts, hopefully some of the most expensive properties we've got. If you have any water, expensive properties we've got, tucked out over here. A lovely view over our city. We filled this in with a little bit of Ant Avenue, just to compensate for our slight industrial demand. And that, ladies and gentlemen, has been the city. It started off as a very small little village, tucked in over here, and has become the city. Zoom all the way out. The city of Animallia. Thank you very much for watching this series. I've thoroughly enjoyed being your host and your player. I really look forward to my other Let's Plays. We may be coming back to City Skylines in the distant future. I've been playing around with the map editor a fair bit, and we might look at what else we can possibly do with that. I just realised this is actually a lake. So it is actually the only way you can get in and out is here. So if we were going to expand, maybe. Again, thank you very much for watching. I have been the Marmoset. This has been Animallia in the game of Cities Skylines with the expansion pack After Dark. Thank you very much for watching this series. Please remember to like, comment, or subscribe.